reminiscent of Phil Taylor's performance. Always in control. Some hairy moments, but there's never really much doubt that they're going to wrap the game up and progress, is there?
Well, you could just tell by Vincent van der Voort and his reaction in the interview that I was doing with him after, just sheer relief. Sheer relief getting past the first round. And Michael van Gerwen is well on his way to doing that, but of course he has had the added weight on his shoulders of everybody expecting him to be convincing, expecting him to put on a show, and he can't do that every single time. So he'll be thinking, I've come in the last match of the first round, I'm going to win, and then I'm going to get ready to take on Peter Wright on Sunday. 49.
Credit to Paul Lim here. He's played really well. A couple of crucial darts missed at a double. A couple of wayward darts. 8-1-40s and 8-ton pluses. He's matching MVG for 140s. This leaves the ball for a 1-3-2. Well, he's missed 1-3-5 on the ball. Now 1-3-2. Hit a 170, of course, but it was only in the scoring phase. Don't get carried away.
It's never dull watching Michael van Gerwen. Yeah, Paul Lim, the crucial misses, second leg of that second set, two darts at tops to go 2-0 up. He's had problems on this side of the board, hasn't he? He has missed so many darts at double 16 and double 8. Yeah, 2 from 13 over that side of the board, and 18. I guess that tells its own story, doesn't it?
Yeah, you want to put that right. With this start, possibly? With this start, possibly?
8.
Oh, my goodness.
Paul, you require 160, sir.
Look, MVG's face, not happy. Can he be punished in an extreme way? 60-57 ball. Capable, we know that, but not on 16. This occasion.
Michael, you require 8. Well,
perhaps on this side of the board. Oh, how many chances does he want? The answer is 9. 9 darts and a double. 7 out of 32. His finishing tonight.
Well, if Michael did want to lay down a marker to prove that he is playing the best darts of anyone in the world, it's not going according to plan. Of the first round, Barney was the man. Gary Anderson was superb. Scott Rand was superb. 86. Robert Thornton, just to mention a few. What a tournament awaits.
No, 93. We have touched on this, but potentially the last 16 could be the best last 16 we've seen in any darts tournament ever.
57.
Well, each event that goes by just seems better and better to me. He's in. We'll switch. Treble 18.
98.
Come on, Paul. Pop the little 170. Get the crowd on their feet.
86. Paul, you require 170.
What a good dart. Oh, Wayne Mardle is nodding his head. Mardle thinks it's going in. Oh, and it is. Brilliant, brilliant dart. The singer, Paul Slinger, slings it in the middle.
I'll tell you why I fancied that, Stu. The first start was sheer perfection, just asking for another 60. Paul Lim, day in, day out, plays soft tip darts. All he does is goes for bullseyes. Since he's been playing this game and the prelim, he's probably gone for 6 or 7 bullseyes. He has not missed the 25 as yet. It was just a matter of time before the bullseye went in. I don't appear a genius, but I told you, didn't I?
You did. Absolutely. Mystic Mardle here at the Alley Pally. A lot of people have been asking me on Twitter the big difference between the darts that we see here and soft tip darts. What is the big difference?
It's a different game entirely. The trebles on the soft tip are three times the size. The doubles are three times the size. The 25 and the bullseye is three times the size.
Well, there you go. At Sky Sports Darts. Always glad to get your comments and your photos, even the odd video. Especially if you've been here or are going to be here over the next 10 days or so. 60.
Another treble 20. Really needs another one. You see Michael behind, he's practicing his throw. Just give it a couple of seconds, Michael, you'd be able to actually release the dart. He couldn't wait.
Double 18. Full in was waiting. And there we go. A trademark celebration, 116. And finally, a big combination finish goes in for Van Gerwen.
Well, he's missed so many darts at doubles, but not that time. Seems to be better on double top, double 10, even double 16. 4, double 18 is hit with no problem. But double 16 and double 8 are showing signs here that he's getting frustrated. This could be the final leg. 80. Well, that was a bit of a fallout. As you see there, the flight taking the penetration away from the dart entering the board.
Whatever happens, Paul Lim has produced one of the highlights of the tournament so far.
100. The top two in the betting, Phil Taylor and Michael Van Gerwen. Interestingly enough, if this match ends right now, Stu, they will not be in the top 10 of the averages. Incredible.
81. They will improve.
Well, I'm assuming they will, but they've got to prove it.
Yeah.
It's okay being a favourite in the bookies. You've got to be a favourite on the dartboard.
105. How would you assess Michael Van Gerwen's performance?
Lackluster. Phil Taylor's performance was poor. Phil Taylor still averaging 93, 94. Many more 55. Gears for the pair of them.
100.
On first round form, got to say, Barney doesn't have a lot to worry about, does he? If he carries on, he wins!
Well, the mouth-watering prospect of Barneveld against Gary Anderson in the last 16.
100. Michael Uruguay, 100.
This to win it! And he took this out in the last leg.
Treble 20. Not going to get a shot. To keep this match alive. 109.
What a fantastic 170 out from Paul Lim earlier in this set. We look at the ball. We looked at treble 18, so Van Gerwen returns, 49. You would presume, to wrap it all up.
Double 20, double 10.
36.
Well, ball still lacking 60. A bit of composure for me, Michael Van Gerwen. He's rapid, but those were quicker than normal. This to go, two legs all in this third set. Got to move over. Gets the dart up. Double top, gets it, and deserves it. This is not finished yet.
Well, two match darts already gone as far as Michael Van Gerwen is concerned. Paul Lim has won five legs
99.
In this match. Could have won a couple more as well, could easily have won that second set.
If this was match play, it'd be 8-5. As it is, Michael Van Gerwen is only one away 90th. From winning the match. And Paul Lim is a mile away.
140.
Brilliant last start. Yeah, I said lackluster, and I really do still believe that, because that second dart from Michael just lacks the oomph of the first and third. Got to throw the same every time, he knows that. And you see him keep shaking his arm. I think he's feeling 60. A bit of pressure here, I really do.
He's like a jack-in-the-box behind Paul Lem as the veteran is throwing his darts.
42.
Yeah, and you can see the result. Not over just yet.
Paul Lim already hit 11 140s, two more than MVG. 100. Who's the big scorer out of these two? Come on!
Well, that's a great dart. Yeah, to leave tops. Well, he was unlucky. The maximum would have left tops. And Paul Lim, who has given Van Gerwen a severe test here, and the Dutchman still has to get the job done.
Well,
a 12th 140 for Lim. Van Gerwen's already missed two for the match.
Double 10 for a place in the second round. He dispatches a Paul Lim, but Paul played superbly with an 87 average. Smiling, won the prelim, just a game too far. Peter Wright awaits. There could be a bit of needle there. Peter Wright has said Michael Van Gerwen is not good enough.
Well, after 7 days of competition, 40 matches,